हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आज हम स्टार्ट करने वाले क्वेश्चन बैंक दिस इज ऑफ द आयोनिक इक्विलिब्रिया टॉपिक विच इज द थर्ड टॉपिक फ्रॉम द केमिस्ट्री. सो उसमें देखते हैं 1 मार्क के क्वेश्चन. तो 1 मार्क के क्वेश्चन में फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन क्या है, देखो. नेम द बफर विच इज यूज टू डिटरमाइन और वी कैन से दैट विच मेंटेन द पीएच 8 to 10 फॉर द प्रेसिपिटेशन ऑफ कैटायंस ऑफ 3A ग्रुप इन ए क्वालिटेटिव एनालिसिस. सो इसमें कैटायन रेडिकल जो कुछ भी हम डिटेक्शन करते हैं वो वाला प्रैक्टिकल उसमें हमें यूज़ करना होता है ये वाला बफर सॉल्यूशन. पर ये टेक्स्ट बुक में भी दिया है हमें, तो इसके लिए कौन सा बफर यूज़ करना पड़ता है, देखो. हियर वी आर यूजिंग अमोनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड एंड अमोनियम क्लोराइड. दिस बफर इज यूज टू मेंटेन द पीएच 8 to 10 फॉर द प्रेसिपिटेशन ऑफ 3A ग्रुप कैटायंस एंड दैट इज द आंसर. Second question is write the solubility product. Now here we should know what is the solubility product formula or how to write that solubility product. Solubility product of sparingly soluble salt Bi2S3. So here if we consider the ionization, how to write, see, firstly you have to write this reaction Bi2S3, it gives 2Bi3+ 3S2-. After that, we are going to write the solubility product. That solubility product is denoted by the symbol Ksp is equal to. Here we have to take the concentration of cation and concentration of anion, as well as we have to take that number of moles of that cation or anion as a raised power of that concentration. So here we have taken that square bracket, it indicates that the concentration. So first one is the Bi3+. Second one is the S2-. But here we got 2 moles. So here we have to take the square and here 3 moles are there. So we have to take it the raised power 3. So in this way we have to write this reaction and this formula. And here we will get the 1 mark. Next question. What is POH if the hydrogen ion concentration in solution is 1 × 10⁻³. So this is the answer of the first question. This is the answer of the second question. Now we'll discuss the third question answer. So they have given hydrogen ion concentration and it is 1 × 10⁻³ moles per decimeter cube. Firstly, and what we have to find out? We have to find out POH. As they have given hydrogen ion concentration, then we can calculate the pH, and by using that pH we can use that formula pH + POH = 14, and finally from that formula we can find out the POH. Now see how to find out. So firstly, what is the formula for the pH? pH is equal to negative logarithm to the base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration. So minus log to the base 10. What is the concentration of hydrogen ion concentration? That is the 1 × 10⁻³. So minus log value of 1 is 0.0040 will be there, minus 3. Because log of 10⁻³, that is nothing but the whatever raised value is, means that power is nothing but the log value. So here minus 3, and here finally pH is equal to 3. So here we have calculated pH. Now how to find out that POH? See, whenever you want to calculate for the 1 mark, directly you can calculate from this one, pH is equal to 3. But for the your understanding purpose, I am explaining each and every term. So finally, POH plus pH is equal to 14. So POH is equal to 14 minus pH value, and that's why POH for this concentration solution will be 14 minus 3, that is nothing but the 11. So this is the final answer for this question or this numerical. Now we'll discuss the fourth question. Write the relationship between molar solubility, which is denoted by capital S, and solubility product, that is the Ksp for CaF2. That how to find out, that I will explain to you. Molar solubility, which is denoted by symbol capital S, and Ksp, which is for the solubility product. For, or we can say that in between them, what is the relation? Ksp is equal to x raised for x into y raised for y, s, that is the molar solubility raised for x plus y. This is the main formula we have to use whenever we want to calculate the molar solubility or the solubility product. Whose molar solubility and solubility relation we want to find out? That is the CaF2. So here CaF2. When it is in the water, it get dissociated like that. Ca2+ 2F-. So from that one, what is that X? X is nothing but number of moles of cation. Why? Number of moles of anion. So here in front of that Ca+2, nothing is there, means there is a presence of a 1. Here in front of that F-2 is there, means this is the value of Y. So 1 is the X, 2 is the Y. So in this way we have to put the value in this formula. Means 1 raised 1 into 2 raised to 2 into S raised to 1+2. And finally we will get here KSP is equal to 4S3. And this is the relationship between molar solubility and solubility product for this CaF2. Next question. Give any one example of salt derived from the weak acid and weak base. So here we can give two examples also. So out of these two examples, whatever example is simple to you, you can write that one. See, first salt, that is the ammonium cyanide. It is derived from the weak acid. I will write here WA, that is for the weak acid. Weak acid, that is the HCN. And weak base, that is the NH4OH, means ammonium hydroxide. Second one is that ammonium fluoride. In that, weak acid is HF and weak base is ammonium hydroxide. So here we have completed 5 questions of the 1 mark. Now we'll discuss the remaining questions. Now see, these are the 3 remaining questions of the 1 mark. In that 6th one, write the formula to calculate pH. But it is not the normal pH, it is of the buffer solution. So what is the formula? That formula is pH is equal to pKa plus log to the base 10 of concentration of salt divided by concentration of acid. This is the formula we have to use to find out the pH of buffer solution. Next one. Label the one conjugate acid base pair in the following reaction. So, yahan pe firstly we should know that acid, which is related to the proton related concept. So, as we know that acids are proton donor and bases are proton acceptor. So, yahan pe hume pata hona chahiye, proton donor are called as A acids and proton acceptors are called as A base. Now see here, CO3 2-, it is converted into SCO3-, means it has accepted the proton, so it will act as a base. Here H2O has donated the proton and because of donation, there is a formation of a OH-, that's why it will act as a acid because it is proton donor. In the next step, if we consider reverse, it will accept the proton or donate, it will accept the proton. So here it will act as a base. So this is the first pair of this conjugate acid base and this is the second pair of this conjugate acid base. So yahan pe dhyan mein rakhna hai, those are proton acceptor are bases and those are proton donor, they are acids. So according to that, this will donate the proton and this will accept the proton, which is related to each other. According to that, we are giving them number 1. So here we have completed this 7th question also. Now last question, calculate the pOH of 10⁻⁸ molar HCl solution. So they have given here concentration of H+ ion and it is 10⁻⁸ molar. Then how to find out that pOH? For that purpose, firstly we should know that pH value. Then by using that pH plus pOH, we can calculate that value. By using this formula, we can calculate the POH. Now see, firstly, we are going to calculate the pH. And what is the formula? See, pH is equal to negative logarithm to the base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration. According to that, here pH is equal to minus log raised power 10 raised to minus 8. So according to that, pH value will be 8. So here we have calculated that pH. Now we have to calculate the POH, and for that purpose, POH is equal to 14 minus 8, and that is nothing but the POH is equal to 6. So simply here we have calculated that POH value from the hydrogen ion concentration. तो ऐसे करके हमने सिंपली कंप्लीट कर दिया वन मार्क क्वेश्चन. तो ऐसे ही सेकेंड मार्क मतलब जो कुछ भी दो मार्क्स के क्वेश्चन है उनके आंसर मिलने के लिए विद एक्सप्लेनेशन मिलने के लिए या फिर समझने के लिए हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करो. थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू.